You know, life is frequently kind of insane, and sometimes your only defense is to laugh at whatever you can, whether at your surroundings, your circumstances, or your own idiotic moments. Join us as we take a trip down our absurd memory lane.
Now a toast. You don't stop laughing because you grow old. You grow old when you stop laughing.
Cheers.
Cheers, Dallas.
What you're about to see, Dallas, you will want probably a bottle of something to watch the rest of this tape, wouldn't you say? It's our present to you.
Probably need a bottle before you start the tape, is my idea. I mean, you should be halfway to looped right now, or this isn't going to make any sense. Anyway.
But it's our present to you. Some of it we got from experience. Some of it we got from observations of others. And some of it we just downright stole material from people. So enjoy. Have a good one. Mm-mm.
What is that, apple juice?
Myself, I like to start each day with a smile and a how do you do and get it the hell out of the way.
I'm going to come over here and get ready to make this film for you, you little darling. You're going to be blessed. This is going to be one of the luckiest days in your life, honey, because I'm going to give you all the secrets.
Animals can be funny enough on their own, but I can never get enough of Chris's ability to turn ordinary animal viewing into comedy. He talks for animals, which cracks me up every time, like when we saw seals clustered on a buoy surrounded by killer whales.
Hope you're seeing those whales.
I am.
Puckered up that seal. It was close. Is that a killer whale? Move up higher on this thing.
The brave little seals on the buoy.
Was those killer whales? Did anybody see? Was they killer whales? What was they? Orcas? Orcas? I ain't going swimming. I bet you could. I bet we could drive right up to those seals and they wouldn't get off of that.
Not right now, no.
I'm not sticking no fin in the water.
We came upon a grouse in the road and he up and gave him a British accent.
Like a parade marshal, he's just leading us along here. Mm-hmm. Come on. This way. Walk this way, gentlemen. Walk this way. I say.
Did you ever stop to think and forget to start again?
He even gave crabs their own voice as he filmed them.
Damn. Waiting for a traffic light. Here we go. All right, Fred. Hi, Mom. How's the wife and kids?
And he had a conversation with Hawaiian minas there as well. One time he interpreted what ravens were discussing.
People all over the place. Damn, things. There are birds everywhere. I don't like them. Only dogs. Oh, what the hell? Damn, people all over the place.
Trying to figure out what the heck this is and where it came from and what it's doing here.
I think it's a ghost ship. Probably been sailing these seas for uncounted years. Captained by a spirit crew. I think they just turned it loose to go back to where it came from. Born free, as the wind blows, as free as the grass grows. No, it is born free.
Probably one of the most amazing animal vocal feats Chris performed was on our first vacation on video in 2003 at Kaufman Cove, Alaska, where he discovered he could call all the crows over to our campsite. I'm not sure where he got the call, it just happened one day. It could be completely quiet, and his call to them brought them in hordes every time, as if they were having major arguments with him.
I can't keep this still, I'm laughing too hard.
There'll be things that happen to you, you got no control over it, just other people's rudeness.
We've done some strange things at times with what we've seen. Doesn't this look like a do-si-do hoedown to you?
Wave from your seats and out on the floor, bring the girl that you adore. Honor your partners. Honor your corners. Alamand left. Alamand right. Promenade your gal and I'll promenade mine. Oh boy, won't that be fine. Then promenade your honey. Comb your hair, button your shoe. Promenade like you always do.
And I guess Chris is rubbing off on me, too, because I'm starting to talk for pelicans now.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, ho, ho, that was funny. Oh, yeah, Nero, a real knee slapper.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. He's got some kind of fish or frog or something. He can't get it down. You see him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, would he swallow a bicycle?
Because there's a lot of stuff you do in your life that's embarrassing, and you just as soon forget.
Well, Darcy is the advanced scout. She's looking up ahead, and she just announced, more bear poop. We're running into it all over the place. I guess the curiosity we have, or we got to run into the customer that made this.
In 2009, we went on a recommended hike in Sitka, Alaska, and we're told not to worry about the bears. Just make lots of noise, they're more afraid of you than you are of them, blah, blah, blah. So we made noise and saw bear sign and bear tracks.
What in the heck could have made a track like that? Huh, what could it be? Beaver?
It's a prime example of about everything you shouldn't do.
But right as I turned this corner, I ran right into two baby grizzly cubs, followed closely by their mom, as huge as this stuffed grizzly and on her hind legs. Since we were too scared at the time to film the event, Chris decided we could use a green screen image of a grizzly and insert ourselves into the picture to recreate our experience after the fact. On our limited budget, it was pretty lame, but then rehearsals, directed by Mr. Chris Pruitt himself, became more hysterical than the actual event.
No! Where's Mama?
It's gonna be this time. Put some heart into it.
I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
Stop.
Will somebody go to the trailer and get Miss Darcy back here on the set? Now, this is what we're trying to get from you. You're here. You gotta show some emotion. You look up, there's a bear. And you're ready to go. See what I'm getting at? Or
do you know how many people do not do this with their spare time? Oh God, we are weird. We are a weird couple. Okay. Walking along, I see this baby bear. Baby bear, not good. We start backing up. No, where's Mama Bear? There's Mama Bear. I want to run so bad.
Hold on and let her buck us. Here we go.
Oh my God. Baby bear, not good. Back up. No, where's Mama?
We have seen grizzlies that don't seem that scary, but usually from safe distances, like when this poor guy tromped by in the pouring rain. Or when we observed a mama bear trying to get her cubs across the river. She had to cross back several times, but the cubs were having none of it.
The simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your stress.
Finally, she outweighed them and they took the plunge.
Necessities are Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I
Yes, you see grizzlies looking like children out there, and it seems possible that you could get closer without any harm, but it's important to practice self-control.
Some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few. The bare necessities.
For the bare necessities, that's what it means to me. Look for the bare necessities of life.
Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a pawpaw or a
scene
prick-
12, take 2, take 14 or whatever. This one we're going for the gold.
Well, here we are in a nice quiet afternoon. Now watch.
An interesting side note is that he has tried to beckon crows elsewhere in Alaska and in the lower 48, but the call does nothing. Only Coffin Cove crows respond.
Still the king of crows, my children. I just tell what the truth is. I just put it right out there, and you can look at it. You can buy it or not. I mean, if you don't agree with me, you can be wrong. That's fine. There's a lot of people that are.
We found a lot of interesting but sometimes useless things in Alaska. What can you do with a gold nugget that's too big to fit in the truck?
Well, in order to finish up the day, we decided to stop by that store that has everything. You know, wall mics.
Yeah. Don't go away. We'll be right back after a word from our sponsor, Wall Mike.
So we pulled in and we're in luck. It was open. We started browsing around and were amazed by the selection offered. The customer aisles had floors, almost. There was a well-stocked automotive section where you could even buy your own gas pump if you wanted to, and they had real white wall tires. After picking out a new gas pump, you could go next door into the garden department, and there was a ton of decor items that would suit anybody's taste. My goodness, look at this. Now, think what this planter could do for your front yard. Bet you could get a lot of peonies in that baby. It won't be long till somebody takes this beauty home. Then we eased into the patio section and were struck by this patriotic lounging equipment. My goodness. Where the patio display ended, there was a small flower bed that must have belonged to somebody else, like the Boy Scouts. It just didn't look like Mike's normal handiwork. But here we found the off-road display, and all I can say is wow. Mike's off-road stock is a little old, but it was all of proven design. This truck, for instance, could obviously carry a big load, and you could tell it was very experienced. Now here's a good-looking dog sled, and another located conveniently on the roof. You can even get a convertible top for your reindeer. Wow! And there was a mobile home section complete with trash. It's a real turnkey operation. For customer comfort, Mike's has clean and pleasant restrooms located right next to the kitchen supplies. Just look at that dandy selection of appliances. Oh, and ladies, there's even a small women's fashion department for you. If you want, you can take all your purchases home in Mike's own truck. Man, what a day. Just a few dollars puts the keys in your pocket. And of course, there's the sign shop. I asked you to look at this inventory of signs. Could you want anything more? And if you want to arouse the old feelings of nostalgia, doesn't this just tighten you up all over? Those were the days.